Brothers and sisters in Christ, today's readings introduce Jesus as a prophet and explain how prophets and other messengers from God inevitably suffer rejection from their own people. Jesus arrived in his hometown, and on the Sabbath, he taught in their synagogue. We see a combination of feelings from the listeners. First, there is an excellent expression of marvel and wonder. Where did this man get all this? What is this wisdom that has been given to him? But this feeling quickly vanishes. The feelings of wonder and amazement get distorted into feelings of contempt and rejection. One of the most challenging places to live our Christian life is in our home. Home is where we know each other best, and home is where our authentic self comes out the most often. There are several reasons why the people in his hometown of Nazareth did not recognize and accept Jesus. First, they were in error. They thought they knew what a Messiah should be. They rejected Jesus because he did not conform to their mistaken idea of a true Messiah. They thought they knew Jesus, that he is the carpenter, the son of Mary, a simple and ordinary guy next door. They were very sure of this because they have known him since childhood. What they did not know was his divinity hidden behind his humanity. They were familiar with him, but it was only on the superficial level. This also happens to us. Many of us are cradle Catholics, so we have become too familiar with Mass, the rituals, the biblical readings, the homilies, and the sacraments. Unfortunately, this familiarity can breed contempt. For example, for many Catholics, the Sunday Mass has become too familiar, too ordinary, and too routine. There is familiarity, but many times there is no intimacy with Jesus. It becomes so easy then to reject him in favor of something new and exciting. This is why our priority always change. When there is sports or some other celebration going on, we say, oh, our priority is sports, so we do not come to the church. There is no Mass on that Sunday for us. Second, the people of Nazareth did not recognize and accept Jesus because a prophet is not without honor except in his native place and among his own kin and in his own house. A prophet is the spokesperson of God. He speaks what God wants to say to his people, whether they like the message or not. In the past, God spoke through human instruments, but now God speaks through his own Son, Jesus. It is not surprising, therefore, that he will be rejected, even by his own town people, because his message and teachings run counter to their values and preconceived notions and ideas about God. And again, this happens to many of us. We reject the messenger because we do not want to hear the message. The truth always hurts, and that is why the messenger of the truth is usually rejected. All prophets in the Bible were killed, not by outsiders, but by their own people. And finally, the people of Nazareth lacked the most important element to be able to accept Jesus, the gift of faith. The Gospel says, he was amazed at their lack of faith. If faith can move mountains, lack of faith builds mountains that blocks the hand of God. Nothing is impossible with Jesus, but he is just could not do any miracle in his hometown because of their lack of faith. Working a miracle for people who have no faith will do more harm than good. As a curses, for those who do not have faith, no miracle is enough. For those who have faith, no miracle is necessary. It seems that the most challenging place for God to reveal His own self is in what is most familiar to us. We all have our own Nazareths or hometowns. The tragedy of life in the hometown is that we can easily lose that sense of mystery and sacredness, not only in the people and events with which we are most familiar, but also in ourselves. For example, just look at your marriage. Look back to the first years of your marriage and see how differently you treat your spouse today. The same with the children. Many times their attitude towards their parents change as they grow older and are influenced by the secular world. The lesson we should learn from today's gospel is to avoid the temptation to see only the negative in the lives of those who are close to us. If we can overcome that temptation, we will be able to focus on the presence of God alive in our lives. This should be the first and primary thing we seek to discover each and every day in our life. Amen.